Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss some important questions from the topic Substantial Acquisition of Shares. So this is an important topic for your SEBI grade examination. So friends, if you like this video, then do subscribe to our channel. So let us see question 1. What is the correct definition of frequently traded shares? So there are SEBI regulations of 2011 regarding substantial acquisition of shares and takeovers. So according to these regulations, the definition of frequently traded shares is that the trading turnover in the past 12 months, it should be at least 10% of the total number of shares. So the turnover of the shares in the past 12 months, it should be at least 10% of the total number of shares. So if they are at least 10%, then they will be called frequently traded. And if the turnover is less than 10%, then it will be called infrequently traded. So this is an important question. This was asked in the SEBI grade examination of 2018. So the correct answer is option B. Now moving on to the next question, question 2. As per Securities Contract Regulation Rules 1957, what is the maximum permissible non-public shareholding in a listed company? So you know, there is Securities Contract Regulation Act of 1956. And similarly, there are Securities Contract Regulation Rules 1957. So as per Rule 19A of these rules, the maximum permissible non-public shareholding in a listed company, it is 75%. So the maximum non-public shareholding is 75% and the minimum public shareholding, it is 25%. So if you know one of these, the other can be derived, right? So the question can be asked in one of the two ways. They can ask you what is the minimum public shareholding and they can also ask you what is the maximum non-public shareholding. So accordingly you have to answer. So in this question, the correct answer is option D, 75%. Now next question, question 3. What is the minimum threshold of acquisition of voting rights at which open offer is required? So as per the SEBI regulations of substantial acquisition and takeover, regulations 2011, so if the acquirer acquires 25% or more voting rights due to acquisition of shares, then he is required to make a public announcement, right? So he is required to make a public announcement of open offer. So the threshold is 25%, right? So the correct option here is option D, 25%. Next, question 4. SEBI Substantial Acquisition of Shares and Takeover Regulations 2011 provides for two types of open offers. Mandatory and voluntary. In case of mandatory open offer, what should be the minimum size of open offer as a percentage of total shares of the target company? Now, before discussing the question, I would like to tell you that as per the regulations, open offer, they are of two types. So it can be mandatory open offer and it can also be voluntary. So mandatory open offer, it is further subdivided into two. So it can be for direct acquisition of shares or control and it can be for indirect acquisition of shares or control. So as per these regulations, the minimum size of open offer in case of mandatory open offer is 26% of the total shares, right? So minimum offer size is 26% of the total shares. So the correct option here is option D. Now question 5. So before discussing this question, I would like to tell you that we have posted this quiz on our website. Also, a lot of other quizzes on different topics for our SEBI grade examination are being posted. So do attempt these quizzes to see your preparation level. Also, a lot of other quizzes for other examinations like SEBI Grade-A, UGC NET, etc. They are also being posted. So attempt those quizzes. The link for the website is provided in the description section below. Now question 5. SEBI Substantial Acquisition of Shares and Takeover Regulations 2011 provides for two type of open offer, mandatory and voluntary. In case of voluntary open offer, what should be the minimum size of open offer? So I just told you that there are two types of open offer, mandatory and voluntary. And I told you that in mandatory, the minimum offer size is 26% of total shares. But in voluntary open offer, the minimum offer size is to acquire 10% of the voting rights. So minimum 10% of the voting rights, right? So the acquisition should be for at least 10% of the voting rights of the target company. So accordingly, the correct option here is option A, 10% of voting rights. Now next question 6. So as per SEBI regulations 2011, an open offer is an offer made by the acquirer to the shareholders of the target company, inviting them to tender their shares in the target company at a particular price. So this is just a definition of open offer. So it can be mandatory or voluntary. So I have already told you. Now there are some statements. So you have to see which statement is correct and which is not. So statement 1, an acquirer is required to give open offer to the shareholders of target company if on acquiring shares of the target company, he becomes entitled to 20% or more voting rights in the target company. Now statement 1 is incorrect. Why? Because I told you that the threshold limit above which open offer is required to be made is 25%. So it is not 20%, it is 25%, right? And statement 2, it says the voluntary open offer shall be made for acquisition of at least 10% of the voting rights in the target company. So this statement is right. So I have just discussed this in the previous question only. And statement 3, the mandatory open offer needs to be for at least 25% of total shares of the target company. So again, this statement is wrong because I told you that the minimum offer size in case of mandatory open offer is 26% of the total shares. So it is not 25, it is 26. 25% is the threshold for making open offer, but the size, minimum size of open offer, it is 26%, right? So do not get confused between the two. They are two different things. So statement 1 and 3 are incorrect and statement 2, it is correct. So the question is asking you which of the above statements are incorrect. So statement 1 and 3 both are incorrect. So the correct option is option E, statement 1 and 3. Now next question, question 7. So before discussing this question, I would like to tell you that I have also discussed this topic on our Telegram group. So we regularly conduct quizzes and post questions. Also, a lot of relevant information regarding various examinations is being shared. So do join the Telegram group and get the benefits. The link for the group is provided in the description section below. Now question 7. Chapter 3 of SEBI regulations 2011 contain provisions about the open offer process. So we are given 3 statements. Let us read the statements. Statement 1, the acquirer needs to appoint a merchant banker as the manager of open offer. So statement 1 is right. It is mandatory to appoint a merchant banker and the merchant banker should be registered with SEBI. So merchant banker is eligible to be appointed as manager of the open offer. So basically he will manage all the formalities regarding open offer. So statement 1 is right. Statement 2, acquirer is required to make public announcement of open offer after publishing the detailed public statement. Now this statement is wrong. Why? Because the order is not correct. Because as per the regulations, the process is that first of all, manager is appointed, then public announcement is made, then detailed public statement is published, and after that, draft offer letter is being filed with SEBI. So this is the order. So statement 2 is incorrect because public announcement is made before publishing detailed public statement and not after. So statement 2 is incorrect. And statement 3, acquirer needs to create an escrow account in which a portion of consideration payable under open offer will be kept. Now statement 3 is right. So basically escrow account, so this account has to be opened by the acquirer, and in this account acquirer needs to deposit a minimum amount. So this minimum amount is a percentage of the consideration payable. So in case of open offer, the acquirer has to pay the shareholders of the target company some money. So the acquirer will get shares and in return he will give money. So he is required to deposit a minimum sum of money for the security of the shareholders, right? So this is escrow account. So this statement is correct. So you can see statement 2 only is incorrect. So the question is asking you which of the following statements is incorrect. So correct option is option B, statement 2. Now next question 8. As per SEBI regulations, an acquirer is required to create an escrow account in which a portion of consideration payable under open offer will be kept as security. What percentage of the first 500 crore rupees of consideration is required to be kept under escrow account? So in the previous question, I told you that the acquirer is required to deposit a minimum amount in the escrow account. So what is that amount, right? So as per the regulations, on the first 500 crore of the consideration payable, acquirer is required to deposit 25% of the consideration. So which comes out to be 125 crore. 25% of 500 crore is 125 crore. And on the balance, the acquirer is required to deposit 10% of the balance. So let me explain this with the help of an example. So let's suppose the consideration payable is 700 crore, right? So let's suppose the consideration payable comes out to be 700 crore. So as per the regulations, on the first 500 crore, acquirer is required to deposit 25%. So 25% of 500 is 125 crore. And on the balance 200 crore, in this case, balance is 200, he is required to deposit 10%. So 10% of 200 is 20 crore. So the total comes out to be 145 crore. So this is the regulation. So the question is asking you, what percentage of the first 500 crore rupees of consideration is required to be kept under escrow account? So it is 25%. So the correct option here is option D. Now next question 9. Section 15H of the SEBI Act 1992 contains penalty for non-disclosure of acquisition of shares and takeovers. What is the minimum penalty? So Section 15H of the SEBI Act, so there are three principal acts: SEBI Act, Depository Act and Securities Contract Regulation Act. So Section 15H of the SEBI Act, it contains penalty for non-disclosure of acquisition of shares and takeovers, right? So the question is asking you the minimum penalty. So as per this section, the minimum penalty is rupees 10 lakhs and it can extend to rupees 25 crore or 3 times the amount of profit, whichever is higher. So the minimum penalty is rupees 10 lakh. So the correct option here is option D. Now final question. So as per SEBI regulations 2011, an open offer is an offer made by the acquirer to the shareholders of the target company, inviting them to tender their shares in the target company at a particular price. For how many working days an open offer is required to be kept open? So this question is to be done by you. I'm not going to tell you the answer now. So mention your answers in the comment section below. Then afterwards I will post the right answer. So friends, if you have learned anything new from this video, then do subscribe to our channel to get more notifications and updates. Have a nice day.